This tutorial shows how to change the font, font size, and font color in Microsoft Word. Hello, my name is Erin. I'm a technical writer and editor who shares step-by-step software tutorials and writing tips for the real world on this channel and on my blog at erinwrightwriting.com. Today's tutorial shows three ways to change the font, font size, and font color in Microsoft Word. First, we'll use the font options in the ribbon. Then, we'll use the mini toolbar. Finally, we'll use the font dialog box. I'll be using Word for Microsoft 365. The steps are the same in Word 2019, Word 2016, Word 2013, and Word 2010. However, your interface might look slightly different in those older versions of the software. In Word, the main toolbar at the top of the screen is called the ribbon. The ribbon offers most of the font options the majority of users will need for general content. To begin, select the Home tab in the ribbon if you're not already there. If your document is blank and you want to create font settings before you begin typing, you don't have to worry about selecting text. If your document already contains text, select the text with the font you want to change. To select the entire document, PC users can press Ctrl plus A on their keyboard. Alternatively, you can select Select in the editing group and then select Select All from the drop-down menu. Next, select the font menu arrow and choose a new font from the drop-down menu. This menu lists the fonts installed on your computer, so your fonts may differ from the fonts shown here. Now, select the font size menu arrow to choose a new font size. The numbers represent typography points. Each point is 1/72 of an inch. You can also select the Increase Font Size or Decrease Font Size buttons to increase or decrease the font by 1 point. If you want to change the font color, select the Font Color menu arrow and then choose a new color from the drop-down menu. For additional color options, select More Colors. When the Colors dialog box appears, you can choose a color from the Standard tab, or enter a custom color in the Advanced tab. Before we leave the ribbon, note that you can also select the Change Case button to choose sentence case, lowercase, uppercase, capitalize each word, or toggle case. Your text should change to your new font choices immediately. The mini toolbar offers many of the same font options as the ribbon without having to leave the text. To begin, select and then right-click the text to display the mini toolbar. Then select the menu arrows to select a font, font color, or font size. The mini toolbar also includes the increase font size or decrease font size buttons to increase or decrease the font by 1 point. Once again, your text should change to your new font choices immediately. The font dialog box takes a few extra steps to use, but it offers advanced options that aren't available in the ribbon or the mini toolbar. To begin, select the Home tab in the ribbon. Then select the text with the font you want to change. Once again, disregard that step if your document is blank. Next, select the Dialog Box Launcher in the Font group. When the Font dialog box appears, select a new font, font size, and font color. You can also select the Advanced tab for additional options for character spacing and open type features. After making your choices, select the OK button. Your text should change as soon as the font dialog box closes. As always, remember to save your file to save your changes. I have created many other videos about Microsoft Word, including how to adjust line spacing in Microsoft Word and how to add page numbers in Microsoft Word. Please see the complete list in the playlist titled How to Use Microsoft Word, which is linked in the description box below. The companion blog post for this video showing all the steps we just performed appears on erinwrightwriting.com, which is also linked below. Feel free to leave me a comment if there's a specific topic related to Microsoft Word, Adobe Acrobat, or Google Docs that you'd like me to talk about in the future. And please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss future tutorials, and give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching.